Hi guys, in this video we will learn about Hay Bridge. You can see that Hay Bridge is used to find out the unknown inductance of a coil, and the main difference between Hay Bridge and Maxwell Bridge is that in the Maxwell Bridge you can see that there is a capacitor and resistor connected in parallel in the first term. However, in Hay Bridge the capacitor and resistor are connected in series. So this is used to find out the unknown inductance of a coil. Now let us write the balance equation of an AC bridge. We know that the balance equation of the AC bridge can be written as Z1, Z4 is equal to Z2, Z3. So from this picture we can find out the impedance values of each arms. So let us consider the first arm, that is Z1, that is the impedance of the first arm. We can see that there is a resistor R1 is in series with a capacitor. So the reactance of the capacitor is given by 1 by J omega C1. So for mathematical analysis purpose, we can rewrite this as R1 minus J by omega C1. That is, when we can write 1 by J as minus J. So the equation will be modified like this. And we can also see that Z2, that is impedance of the second arm, is given by R2 because there is only one resistor R2 in that. And we can also see that Z3, that is impedance of the third arm, is given as R3 because there is only one resistor R3 in that arm. And we can see Zx, that is the impedance of the fourth arm, is given by the series combination of a resistor and an inductor. So we know that the resistance value is Rx plus series combination of inductor, so the reactance of the inductor is J omega Lx. So these are the equations for impedances in the different arms. Now let us substitute these impedance values into the balance equation of the AC bridge and find out the values for unknown inductance Lx. So we can write the equation as R1 minus J by omega C1 into Rx plus J omega Lx is equal to R2 R3. That is, because this term is Z1, this term is Z4, this is Z2 and this is Z3. We got this equation by substituting each impedance values into the AC balance equation. So now we can multiply the terms inside. Let us multiply R1 to this term and R1 to this term, and also J by omega C1 to this term and J by omega C1 to this term, and let us find out what we will get. So we will get like R1 Rx plus J omega R1 Lx minus J Rx by omega C1 minus J square into omega Lx by omega C1 is equal to R2 R3. So from this part of the equation you can know that J square is nothing but minus 1, and the omega and omega will cancel here. So the only remaining term will be a plus Lx by C1. So we can rewrite the equation as R1 Rx plus J omega R1 Lx minus J Rx by omega C1 plus Lx by C1 is equal to R2 R3. So we will give this as the equation number 1. Now let us try to separate the real term and imaginary. That is, we are going to equate the real term and imaginary term in the LHS and RHS. You can see that only real term is existing in the RHS side. So we can rewrite the equation as R1 Rx plus Lx by C1 is equal to R2 R3. We will get this equation by equating the real terms of the equation. Now let us equate the imaginary terms of the equation. We will get omega R1 Lx minus Rx by omega C1 is equal to 0. So this equation can be written as omega R1 Lx is equal to Rx by omega C1. So from this equation we can write equations for Lx and Rx. What is the equation for Lx? So Lx is given by Rx divided by omega square C1 R1. And we can also find out an equation for Rx. So Rx is given by omega square C1 R1 Lx. Now our idea is to substitute Lx and Rx in equation number 2. Let us substitute the value of Lx. We can get R1 Rx plus Rx by omega square C1 square R1 equal to R2 R3. So if we take the LCM, we can get an equation like omega square C1 square R1 square Rx plus Rx equal to R2 R3 R1 C1 square omega square. So let us take Rx common. We can write Rx is equal to Rx into 1 plus omega square C1 square R1 is equal to R2 R3 R1 C1 square omega square. So from this you can get an equation for Rx that is equal to R2 R3 R1 C1 square omega square divided by 1 plus omega square C1 square R1. So this is the equation for the resistance in the unknown branch. So thus we can see that when we substitute the value of Lx into equation number 2, we got an equation for Rx. Now let us substitute the value of Rx into equation number 2 and find out the value for Lx. We can rewrite the equation number 2 as R1 omega square C1 R1 Lx plus Lx by C1 is equal to R2 R3. And if you are taking LCM and multiplying to the right side, you can write an equation like R1 square omega square C1 square Lx plus Lx is equal to R2 R3 C1. Now we can take Lx in the RHS as common. So we can write Lx into 1 plus R1 square omega square C1 square is equal to R2 R3 C1. So from this we can find out an equation for Lx that is given by Lx is equal to R2 R3 C1 divided by 1 plus R1 square omega square C1 square. That is, when we substituted the value of Rx into equation number 2, we got an equation for Lx, that is Lx is equal to R2 R3 C1 by 1 plus R1 square omega square C1 square. Thus we have got the equations for the unknown resistance in the branch and the unknown inductance in the fourth branch. So these equations are the equations for the unknown values in a Hay bridge, and we can notice that both the terms, that is the equation for Rx and Lx, contain an omega term, that is nothing but the angular frequency. So we have to notice that these equations are depending on the frequency, so the frequency of the voltage source must be known accurately for finding out the values of Rx and Lx in the case of Hay bridge. Thank you for watching.